So I got up this morning and I told my wife, I said, I have to do a speech today. I need my dress and shorts. And she said, all your shorts are the same. I said, yeah, I know, but I know which ones are the dressy ones. And so, thanks for having me. So I like to do talks. I like to do all my talks in a specific format, which is, what's the big idea? I want to leave you with a big idea. And I want to try to move you from point A to point B. And the big idea I want to leave you with today is that everybody needs a personal board of directors. And if you're like me, I had no idea what that phrase meant until I was like 27 years old and I was working in that space. And so if you're a Star Wars fan, it's your Jedi Council. Who is your Jedi Council? And if you're a Lord of the Rings fan, it's your Council of Elrond. Right? And they decided to send Frodo on his path to do it by yourself. The world has really deceived us into thinking that Steve Jobs did it by himself. And that Bill Gates was a lone gunman, so genius, and it's a lie. Don't believe anybody that tells you they did it by themselves. Because we live in a world where you have to have a team. You have to have a team. Who your friends are really matters. And I want to tell you my story and how I kind of stumbled in to a board of directors that I really didn't deserve. And so I think that, you know, my journey is a little bit, I think it's a little bit weird, it might not be weird, but you know, I grew up in the inner city, I grew up in Los Angeles Heights, which is right off of 10 West Avenue. I'm an SAISD guy, raise your hand if you have any, if there's any ISD guys here. And so I went to Foy Middle School, which is the very first magnet school that SAISD ever rolled out. It's where the Castro Brothers went, where our state representative David McNally went. And I didn't want to go, because all of my friends were going to Whittier and then Edison, and I wanted to play football. And as you can imagine, I'm not very big right now. And I wasn't very big back then. I don't think I weighed more than 90 pounds until my senior year. And so my mom said, hey, you're going to go to this magnet program because they can teach a foreign language. Now, I don't want to go to that school, and I don't want to learn a foreign language. And she said, no, you're going to go. And I said, well, what language am I going to learn? And she said, you're going to learn Latin. I said, well, I don't want to learn Latin. Who speaks Latin? She goes, well, cool. I said, well, I don't want to talk to a poet. And so she said, no, you're going to go to Foy. So I went to Foy, and it was great. And then my older sister got accepted into another magnet called Health Careers, which is on the north side. And Health Careers is a medical-only high school. Raise your hand if you know it, anybody knows about Health Careers. So, all right. So I did not want to go to Health Careers. I wanted to go to Edison, and I wanted to play football. Again, I probably would be on crutches right now still if I didn't. And so my mom said, no, you're going to go to Hoopers. And I said, why do I have to go to Hoopers? Well, because you're going to get the medical field. I said, I want to get the medical field. Sit down, you're going to go. So I went to Hoopers. And in Health Careers is where I found three of my board of directors. My wife, I met, I actually couldn't stand her the first time I met her. Luckily, that changed. And then I met a guy named Gasparano and another guy named Lugo, and these guys are on my personal board of directors today. And your junior year of Health Careers, you get on a bus and you intern at a hospital for a whole year. And you wear these really terrible looking shoes. Shoes that I would have never wore, you know, outside in public. And so Dax and I, we were on the same bus route, and we went to the same hospital, Downtown Baptist. And while we were there, we interned at different, you know, six different departments, and it was really interesting. And one day, Dax and I were eating breakfast tacos outside of the pharmacy, which I think is actually against the biblical lines. So I don't think you're allowed to do that anymore. And so I was eating tacos, and Dax and I looked at each other and said, you know, I don't want to be in a hospital. That's not going to medicine. And so we made the pinky swear best friend vow right there to not go into medicine because it just wasn't our life. And so I graduated Health Careers couple years later, and I kept in touch with my friend Dax and my friend Luke, and I got a job at HEB, and raise your hand, are there any HEB partners in the house? All right. So I was a partner at number 5, which is now the deck of HEB. Much fancier than when I worked there. And I was working at HEB, and I was cashier, and then I got a good promotion in the produce. I thought it was hot stuff. I just got to tell you. And I was in the produce department, and one day I got a phone call from my friend Dax. And he is on my Jedi Council. And he said, hey man, I got a job at this computer store called Gateway Computers. If you don't know Gateway, it was the old couch buy boxes. Raise your hand if you ever, if you had one. We probably sold you that. I apologize. And Dax called me and he said, hey man, I got a job at this computer place and you need to come work here. And I said, hey bro, I don't know anything about computers. And do you have any idea how fresh the cilantro is this season? I'm not trying to go into computers. And Dax said, he said, it's a blast, I'm learning a ton. And my boss asked me, Do you have, are there any friends that work hard like you? And this is one of the principles that I want to tell you about. Principle one is an A player's role with other A players. Who you think is your friends matter. The people that make you smarter, the people that challenge you, the people that don't get you into trouble, those are your players. And you need to follow them, and you need to solicit them to join your Jedi Council. The second principle was that Max called me every day for 2 weeks, and he said, you're gonna come join me at this company. And I fought it, and I fought it, and finally he said, look, it's 25 centers. I said, well, 25 centers? And so I quit my job at HEB, and I joined him as a receptionist at Gateway Computers. And Gateway is where I learned what a circle was. Gateway is where I registered my LOS 123 at Hotmail account, which is, you know, it's almost as bad as having an AOL account. So don't tell any of my tech friends that I have a Hotmail account. And so Gateway really changed my life. But the key is, was the second principle that I want to tell you about, is that who you solicit to your board of directors, you have to deputize them to speak truth into your life. My best friend Dax can tell me things that I won't let anyone else tell me. If Dax tells me that I'm full of it, and that I'm self-deceived, and that I'm lying to myself, I'll believe it because I know he loves me. I know that he has my best interests in mind. And there are other people that will tell me the exact same things, and I will reject their advice. Who you have on your board of directors matters. You have to deputize someone to speak truth into your life. Later on down the road, we were both working at Gateway. We were working hard. They promoted me to sales. I have to tell you, I was Gateway's worst sales guy of all time. I think I hit my quota zero times. They should have fired me. And at Gateway, we met a guy named James Brown. And James Brown now has a company in Geekdom where I work. And he's got 10 employees, and he has millions of dollars of revenue. And he was the first real sales guy that we ever met. And James left Gateway and went to this little company that he had never heard of called Rackspace. And one day, James called me, and he said, hey man, I'm at this company downtown. It's super small. It's crazy. It's probably going to go out of business. But they buy us food every week. Whatever you want, buy it. It's fun. Whatever you want. It's pretty amazing. And so I left Gateway Computers, and I went to go work at Rackspace. I was the 7th account manager at Rackspace. I was about the 60th employee in the company. And I was convinced that I had committed fraud, and I had deceived my way in this role. I had no idea what the internet was, right? I didn't know what DNS was, and all these things, and I still don't know where. And they're going to bounce me. But the other principle that I want to tell you about is that you have to seek wise counsel. When James called and offered me this job, I went to my oldest brother, Danny, who's on my board of directors. He's on my Jedi Council. And I said, hey, what do you think I should do? And he said, are you going to learn more? I think so. Is it a great opportunity? I think so. Then there's no reason for you not to do it. And that really left an impression on me and really changed my career. Just three people that I've mentioned in these stories changed the entire trajectory of my career. Who you have on your board of directors matters. Who you follow in the battle matters. Who you surround yourself with really matters. And then one day, you know, I was offered a job to move to the UK, and I had never left the 5-block radius of my house. And I was offered to move to London, and I thought, why would I go to London? My mom would always say, don't go to London, they talk funny there. Why would you want to do that? And so I was talking to one of my other board of directors, a woman named Jay Gracia, and I was telling her, this guy keeps offering me a job in the UK office at Rackspace. And she said, look, what do you do? You've never traveled. Go travel. Because when you come back, all your friends are going to be hanging out at the same place, going to the same lake, watching the same movies. And it made so much sense to me, and I said, you know what, I'm going to give it a shot. And I went to the UK, and I traveled the world. I ran with the Bulls in 2005, I climbed on Kilimanjaro, I saw Lance Armstrong when he wasn't nobody, when he was the and changed the way that I viewed the world. And you just, you know, these people had such a momentous impact on my life, and I want to give you that. And so I want to close with this. This is such an amazing program that you're in right now at SayWorks, because you are meeting some of your future board of directors. There's a mentor right now, there's a supervisor, there's a friend that you ride the bus with, there's someone that you interacted in this program, and you need to ask, should they be on my Jedi Council? Because you can't get through this career alone, you can't get through life alone. And I hope that you'll learn from some of my mistakes and seek it proactively, because you'll get there faster than I did. So thank you, SA Works. Thank you for everybody, the companies that support this. And thank you, the interns and the families of the interns, for supporting such a great program. Thank you very much.